myself last night. I'm not sure if Phil or Sarah is in here somewhere, but kudos to them as well. We'll start with a prayer, and during that prayer, hopefully I'll mention some of these things. But I just want to say congratulations to everybody prior to the prayer on a really special accomplishment. To get to the college level, you guys have read all the stats. You know, it's something like 3%, 2%, it depends on which article you're reading. It's very unique to become a college athlete at any level, and it's even more unique to stick with it once you get there. And that stick-to-itiveness, that resilience, and your ability to battle through some of the hardships that are still ahead, but the ones that you've already battled through, really speaks to your character and probably to the character of your family, who has given you some of those intangibles that has allowed you to get to where you are today. On behalf of Archbishop Holman, I would just like to say thank you for making our programs pretty darn good, for taking us to a lot of fun trips and fun rides. We've got a lot of Final Fours in here, whether it was the football state championship runs, whether it was beating St. Bede bowling, which I just saw the other day, or softball, whether it was the Final Four run from girls basketball a couple of years ago, and then a bunch of other stuff like the state championship golfers. Sorry, I should have shut my mouth because I don't want to forget somebody. Because so many of you guys had beautiful runs in the tournament, and being able to follow you, you getting our school excited, baseball, of course, won a state championship. Just being there and bringing the whole community together is always a special part of this tradition here. If you look at the banners up there, those of us who have either been a Holman fan or been around Holman when every one of these teams made their trip, the special thing about it was the way you brought the community together and the way you inspired future generations of Knights. That was my way of stalling for Lola. She's still up. Oh, there's Lola. Come on in, Lola. That was a stall technique. It worked. Lola's going to Center College where Dr. Biden, my mentor of Hope, is going in Kentucky. That's pretty cool. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord, look down upon these student-athletes as they wrap up their four-year journey as representatives of Archbishop Hope. Despite the strong societal forces of the individual that continually press upon these young athletes, help them always embrace the aspects of team that will continue to forge and transform their lives. Traits like sacrifice, unselfishness, grit, servant leadership, these are the true gifts that their sport will hopefully continue to give and teach. In addition, help them understand with clarity that they did not do this alone, that no one really achieves anything alone. The immense support they receive from teachers, coaches, teammates, lessons from wins and losses, great games and games in which they struggle, long car rides and meals provided from moms and dads, or just throwing the ball in the backyard, signing up for teams and leagues and tryouts. All of this was given to them by their parents, their mentors, and their loved ones. So a spirit of gratitude is necessary as well. Finally, as they enter a new team, help them take Holman's core values with them and allow these core values to anchor their personal highs and lows during their next journey. We ask all of this in your name. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. And with that, I'm going to bring up our president, Chris DeMauro, followed by our athletic director, Matt Bain. How about a hand for Chris DeMauro?
I'm going to be very, very brief. Just want to echo Mr. Griffith's words. Congratulations, student athletes. All of you make us very, very proud. It's not lost on any of us, members of the faculty and staff, the amount of work that goes into an accomplishment like this. I know for many of you, that work is not yet finished. You're starting a new chapter, new challenges. I think it is best to remember that the high expectations that we have for you, that your parents have for you,
just five